about our mysterious host?
Well, he serves a damn fine wine, whoever he is.
When a chap buys me a drink, I'd like to know who he is and what's on his mind. But that's just the ruthless killing machine in me.
Why did you come?
Oh, I don't know. Something about the tone of his letter interested me. Please meet me at the Carfax Club today at 4 o'clock or I'll blow up your house. I don't know, I was intrigued.
Yes, mine was the same.
So was mine.
Me too.
Good Lord. I'm Timpson, by the way. Major, Blues and Royals.
Godley, Light Brigade.
Whitlow, Secret Service. Teacher.
Gentlemen, sorry to keep you waiting. Timpson, Godley, Whitlow. Oh, yes. I know all your names. I'm Colonel Susan Draycott, by the way. I don't know how you'd describe me. Some call me an adventurer, some say I'm a damn fool. Personally, I like to think of myself as a fine and fluffy little fun bundle. Are there any questions?
Yes. Why have you brought us here? So far, you've told us nothing.
Gentlemen, it's been said of the 1980s that there are no great adventures left. No great deeds of daring remain undone to challenge British ingenuity and British pluck. Fellows, I say that's nonsense. It's more than nonsense, it's tummy rubbish. There is one great adventure left.
Sir, you're mad, bloody mad, it can't be done.
What can't?
Oh, haven't you said yet?
No.
Oh, sorry, sir, do carry on.
I was just about to. Fellows, what I propose has never been done before. It's difficult and it's dangerous, but I think we can do it. Timpson, would you mind pulling down that map for me?
Sir, you are asking that man to commit suicide.
No, I still haven't said it yet. Timpson. Gentlemen, I propose that we become the first men ever to cross the Antarctic barefoot in pairs, tied together in the manner of a three-legged race, until we reach a point exactly 3 yards to the left of the South Pole.
To the left? You are mad.
No, hang on a moment. I'm beginning to see what you mean. All right, it's a crazy harebrained scheme. Granted, it's an idiotic, suicidal waste of time. Maybe it is the most moronically cretinous pile of drivel anyone's ever spurted.
Yes, all right, Whitlow.
Yes,
thank you.
People will call us unintelligent imbeciles.
Yes, thank you.
Certainly, history will judge us the most stupendously self-indulgent dickheads in living memory. But by golly, I'm game.
Good man!
Yes. Oh, yes. And you can count me in too, sir.
No, Whitlow, not you. You can't come.
Sorry, sir?
I want you to stay behind and liaise.
But why, sir?
Because, Whitlow, because you're blind. And I can't jeopardize these men's lives because one of the members of the expedition happens to be blind.
I beg your pardon, sir?
I said I can't. What's the matter? You're deaf.
Yes, sir.
You're blind and deaf.
No, just deaf, sir.
No, you're blind as well, Whitlow. You keep bumping into things.
Oh, that's just a joke, sir.
Not very funny, is it?
Well, the chaps like it, sir.
Right. All right, Whitlow. I have here an electric carving knife. I'm going to switch it on. And I'm going to throw it at you. If you don't drop it, I'll let you come on the expedition.
I'm sorry, I didn't catch that, sir.
I haven't thrown it yet.
Actually, I was telling a bit of a lie just now.
You mean you're not deaf?
No, I mean I am blind.
You're deaf and blind?
Pardon?
Well, I can't very well let you go on the expedition if you're deaf and blind, Whitlow, can I?
It was a forlorn hope, sir, yes.
Wait a minute. If you're deaf, how can you hear what he's saying?
Good point.
I can lip read.
Ah! But how can you lip read if you're blind?
Oh, whatever you like, sir. I've got some in the car.
Sir? I don't think he can damn well lip read.
Oh, lip read. Oh, I see what you mean. Well, it's like this, sir. It often happens that blind people have very keen hearing and deaf people don't have excellent vision. What's happened in my case is that both my sight and my hearing are perfect because the other is defective. One miraculously compensates for the other.
Poor beggar. Dame Nature has dealt you a couple of queer cards there.
I don't like to grumble, sir.
Nonetheless, I'm afraid you can't come on this expedition.
It's because I'm dumb, isn't it, sir?
What?
All the world hates a mute.
What are you talking about?
It's a talker's world. You can't talk. You're nothing. You're nobody. You're a zero. You're passed over, ignored. They think it means I'm stupid, but I've got ideas. I can think.
Shut up.
Oh, yeah, shut up. That's what they always say to mute, isn't it?
Be quiet.
Right, sir.
Now, this expedition...
If it's because I can't smell, sir.
Sir!
Yes?
Whitlow not being able to go on the expedition has given me an idea about the rest of us. Why don't we, every last man jack of us, simply not go?
I'm not with you.
Call me an old Matty Trousers if you will, sir, but my idea is that we stay at home. We don't go.
You mean call the whole thing off?
I know it's never been done before, sir. That's what makes it so bloody exciting.
By golly, I think you've got something there.
Yes. Well, I'm game. What about you, Whitlow?
Pardon?
Right, that's it then. Let's call it off. Jack it in. Abandon scheme. End of project. Sorry to have wasted your time.
Of course they're real legs.